Governor of Karnataka, Sri Vajubhai Balaji, Principal Scientific Advisor to the Government of India, Dr. R. Chidambaramji, Director, Indian Institute of Science, Professor Anurag Mahanti, Secretary, Department of Biotechnology, Dr. K. Vijay Raghavanji, Secretary, Department of Science and Technology, Dr. Ashutosh Sharma ji, Secretary, Higher Education, Ministry of Human Resource Development, Sri K.K. Sharma ji, Chairman ISRO, Sri Kiran Kumar ji, Chairman TRDU, Dr. S. Christopher, other members of the scientific community present at this round table, as well as those in the adjacent room. Friends, when the program for Bangalore was being finalized, I just expressed my desire to my secretary that when I am going to commemorate the Diamond Jubilee of Vidhan Sabha, of course, that is the temple of democracy. But the democracy without scientists, without farmers, without laborers, and much more, without Indians, can't have any sense in that matter. At that time, I wished that if I could meet the scientists and technologists of Bangalore city, because this city has been and is known as a science city, science and technology city. And of course, my people told me, what will you do there? Because I am not a scientist. My simple reply was that I want to meet my scientists and technologists as a common man, and at the most, as a citizen of this country. I will go meet them, read them, and hear them. And for that reason, I am here amongst you all. Before coming to this place, I had the opportunity to visit your nanotechnology lab today. For the first time, I have seen it with my eyes. And I can say, it's a wonderful lab. I understand that this lab competes with the best in the world. Friends, thank you for welcoming me to Bengaluru in the best possible manner. I have learned so much, and I can feel the excitement that only comes from exploring the frontiers of science. Having met and heard from all of you among the countries, leading intellectuals, scientists, and technologists, and having been told of your plans for action for New India 2022, I am confident that our future is in safe hands. I need not remind you about the relevance of 2022. As we all know, we are going to celebrate the completion of 75 years of our independence in the year 2022. And I think we have to generate the same fervor, the same strength, and the same patriotism to reach our goals, goals of achieving the real meaning of democracy by 2022. The venue for this meeting is so appropriate. The Indian Institute of Science was conceived and has worked through the decades for the cause of science and for the cause of India. nation building is written into its DNA. We can never forget that the very origins of the Indian Institute of Science lie in a request made by Swami Vivekananda to Jamsetji Tata to set up a world-class science research institution in our country. The dream of those two great Indians has come such a long way. While entering this building, our director, Professor Anurag Kumar, he had indicated me the portrait, the statue of Jamsetji Tata. I had narrated to him about this story, about the meeting of our beloved Swami Vivekananda and Jamsetji Tata while they were traveling from India to America. Anyway, you people all know it. Knowledge, discovery and innovation are three or four wheels that take a country forward. The fourth is our society. Each wheel must move in coordination, in peace and in the right direction. The slightest misstep by one will take us in the wrong direction or stall us. As scientists, you have an immense responsibility. You are directly in charge of three wheels, but unless you connect every day with the fourth one, we have no future. Today, India is in an unusual situation. We face enormous challenges. We are to lift our people out of poverty, ensure their health and well-being, and ensure our food and energy security. The size of the challenge is enormous. Listening to you, I have heard how similar hurdles have been overcome by you, right from the inception of the Indian Institute of Science to the growth of the entire Bengaluru ecosystem of institutions. Bengaluru is known for its climate, for being the garden city, and for being a powerhouse of information technology. In nanoscience and material science, we are among the world's best. This is due in no small measure to the leadership of Professor C. N. R. Rao, awarded the Bharat Ratna and truly one of the jewels of Bengaluru and that of our entire country. India is a leader in generic drugs and vaccines, and the biotech startup ecosystem is extraordinarily vibrant here in this city. We must never forget that these successes and the older ones, such as with the Indian Space Research Organization, the DRDO, and the Department of Atomic Energy, all stem from an investment in research. This public investment was aimed at generating new knowledge and discovery. In times, it was complemented by an energetic private sector that converted technology into products. In its essence, science is about human fascination and curiosity. It is about that endless quest for new frontiers. For thousands of years, from the age of Aryabhatta and Charak, India has embraced science and its sense of inquiry. Science has been our intellectual trigger as well as our force multiplier. From eminent scientists such as C.V. Raman to S. Chandrasekhar, G.N. Ramachandran to Ubaid Siddiqui, and C.N.R. Rao to my illustrious predecessor, Dr. Abdul Kalam, it is the investment in curiosity-driven science that has paid off to the society. The saga continues with younger scientists today. Society rightly demands solutions to our day-to-day problems also. On the other hand, scientists must not compromise their quest for knowledge, from atoms to galaxies. These two endeavors are not contradictory. We have seen how ISRO has succeeded through the efforts of late Dr. Satish Dhawan in combining cutting-edge science with helping farmers and in linking ISRO's research applications and innovation with the academic capacities of the Indian Institute of Science. The challenge is to replicate that partnership and that synergy across institutions and across disciplines. Today, you have the opportunity to pioneer a revolution where all the scientific institutes in Bengaluru work together. This was the consensus, I think, after the discussion of today's. They can share their strengths and show by example how science and technology can take us to new heights. The spark from your efforts in Bengaluru can light the flame of knowledge all over the country. It can help take that culture of innovation further and deeper from lab to shop floor, right down to school classrooms. Friends, number of presentations have been made by eminent scientists today, and I appreciate their total commitment to the mission. They, along with their colleagues, are making India proud. We will continue this dialogue to understand and appreciate the new inventions, innovations, initiatives, research. I can say without any doubt that you are the true nation builders. And you have major responsibility in the coming New India 2022. Today, we have the eminent scientists at India Institute of Science, Bengaluru, along with science administrators, including the secretaries of the ministries, and we all have to work together. And closely, to make India as one of the premier scientific nations of the world. With the leadership and wisdom that I have encountered in this room today, I have no doubt that we are on track to achieving these goals. Thank you, and wishing you all the best journey.